I see you around campus sometime. A few things that only HBCU students will understand. We built this with this.
All right.
Of hope. This more than school.
This more than home.
Where slave babies, grandbabies become doctors. We built this library.
Our history and our text.
This our house.
Our home.
Our church.
Trump's administration signed an executive order to help strengthen the country's 104 historically black colleges and universities.
And since then, the administration has done nothing to restore HBCUs.
According to U.S. Representative Jim Clyburn,
there are $755 million still needed in repairs for HBCU campuses.
And it seems like we are at a tipping point.
They tried to axe me down with iron staffs, letting bloody chains run across my folk like whips.
My limbs grow weary as my leaves fall months before autumn,
but my roots
are planted permanent in the soil, fertilized by burning wood.
They tried to axe me down, but here I am. Standing still.
In February of 2017, President Trump and Secretary of Education Betsy DeVos met with the leaders of historically black colleges and universities to discuss a future HBCU initiative. DeVos released a statement following the meeting in which she tied the history of HBCUs to school choice policies.
DeVos received immediate backlash for whitewashing history. HBCUs were created because African Americans could not legally attend white schools, not because we wanted more choices. But according to NPR, the previous academic year saw a 50% increase in enrollment in HBCUs, including multiple minority ethnic groups.
The Huffington Post notes that HBCUs have become an academic safe place for students of color. Despite this, however, HBCUs across the nation are still struggling to maintain economic stability. So through the drama, A Different World, the documentary Tell We Are Rising, the poetry We Built This and Standing Still by Ben Brooks.
Articles from the Huffington Post, Blackman, the New York Times, and personal narratives by us.
We use the platform of speech and debate, academia's oldest tradition,
to preserve one of our nation's oldest academias.
A program.
Some niggas want in line and so bad that they were studied by the torches at night.
But one thing show, white folk better not find out about it. And suddenly, a whole race that had been slumbering for centuries awoke and started out to school.
Hey, yo, why you think so many police on the yard today?
I don't know. Maybe they know that we are the men and women of this generation for years
to go. Revolution jazz. Plus, mama say white folks always waiting for an opportunity.
Junior, we are black students going to a black school. I mean, we are the revolution. And where are you going?
I got practice. You know me and my boys gotta keep it ice cold.
What? Just cause you got your letters don't mean nothing. You still my little brother.
A few things that only HBCU students will understand. Fried chicken Wednesday!
Name for Soul Food Friday.
But everybody knows that the food in the cafe is gonna be fire.
And everybody comes in.
There was a commotion across the yard. Someone called the governor's office and told them that the students at Southern University were surrounding the front office.
The police were ordered to clear the crowd.
Sharon, I told you this was trouble.
B-16s. Shotguns, sidearms, you name it, they had it.
The police had a tank.
Are we about to go to war?
Sharon, they can't just raid our school like this.
We ain't harming no one.
They tried to axe me down with unhallowed chains of metal.
Bark bent our branches, we're never meant to swing. Bodies like carousel in the air.
And if our twigs wither away, by one use or grow for textbook.
Use my lumber for shelter.
Do not turn this timber temple into burning wood, for we cannot smother any more fires.
For we cannot hold
any more smoke. Any more smoke. Damn it. We gotta get out of here.
We knew we had to stay calm. All they needed was a reason. The police officer had rolled a gas bomb right at us. Someone picked it up and threw it back.
Get up, Opus.
Students were running.
Shots fired.
Junior!
There was smoke everywhere, Sharon!
Junior! There were two students on the ground. We thought they got knocked over from everybody trying to get out. Junior! Junior! If I hadn't been there, my brother would still be alive.
Sanctuary, a free slave institution, bold bricks built the solid sustaining opportunity from poverty
to prosperity.
But my HBCU lost funding.
St. Paul's College, established 1888, closed.
Bishop College, established 1881, closed.
Leland University, established 1884, closed.
Western University, established 1865, closed. We built this with brick of hope.
We built this to empower.
We built this to survive. This museum of beautiful black skin, where black history is every month. We built this for our culture. We celebrate on this week, bouncing our bodies to beats of our own liberation. This house we build holds hope. This house we build beats odds, bricks hold. This house can't burn it down, can't break our bricks, can't take our shit no more.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm.
Before I went to Wiley College, I didn't know what it was like for my laughter, my tears, and my anger to all be understood in the same conversation.
Before I went to Wiley College, I never had a place of belonging. My HBCU taught me how to walk with pride, confidence, and how to graduate.
They tried to axe me down. But here I am, standing.